in the second half. And again, McAfee's kick is going to drive Davis into the end zone, and Auburn will take over at the 20-yard line. How about a look at tonight's coaching adjustments brought to you by the Home Depot?
Well, here you see the option. He comes in here, he comes out here, he pitches the ball. Nobody's out here in that area. Three options. He could hand it to the back running. That way, quarterback can keep it or he can pitch it. And let's say this. West Virginia has two turnovers. That's wrong. They've had three. Auburn recovered an onside kick. That's the same as a turnover.
No, Auburn didn't cash that one in. They did cost the Mountaineers an opportunity to get the ball. Some time ran off the clock. That's an opportunity in field position. And Tuberville's Tigers, which have had a lead in every game this season at halftime, three times, falling short in the second half, trying to turn it around in this pivotal game for both teams. Brad Lester shakes one tackle in the backfield, and after JT Thomas missed him the first time, he went down and corralled him again, and it'll be a loss of about a half yard.
Well, that's just a bad job by the offensive line. When you're pulling out there and you see opposite color, you block it. You don't let it run by you and hit the back in the backfield. You block the first thing that shows.
But the adjustment West Virginia made, they're going to attack that offense. You've got to disrupt the rhythm, which is what happened on that play.
West Virginia defensive end Scooter Berry injured in the first half. We saw him limping to the locker room. He's been one of the standout players for the Mountaineers up front, so they'll have to try to slow down this rushing attack without him likely in the second half. Lester again and again, virtually nothing. Might have picked up a yard before Anthony Leonard and Chris Neild were there to stop him. And Leonard had a sensational first half. That is 12th tackle of the night. As you see Leonard trotting for the Mountaineer sideline. I'm going to leave him out there. He's been making every tackle.
Yes, but, you know, the first half, Auburn ran north-south. Their first two plays, Mark, they've gone east-west for a total of about 8 inches per try.
In both plays, West Virginia got penetration on those runs.
7 of 10 on third down in the first half for the Tigers. Cody Burns throwing deep, looking for Tim Hawthorne, and Hawthorne caught it, but he was out of bounds, and Auburn will have to punt it away.
Boy, that looked good to me.
I thought he had the back foot down when he caught it. Let's have a little look.
Well, it's in front of the West Virginia bench. Let's take another look at it here. Great throw, lot of air.
No, good call.
Good call. Great officials. Great official. Great officiating.
Hawthorne very close. We see the back foot in the air, and that one has just a toe on the out-of-bounds line.
What a great start for West Virginia. They sent a message come out this half.
Forcing Auburn three and out. Ellis Langster will return the punt from Clinton Durst. And Durst has struggled this game tonight. And the average kick, a big-time block for Langster. Langster's put it on the ground. West Virginia, a very fortuitous turn of events for the Mountaineers as Boogie Allen was there to scoop it up and avert disaster for West Virginia. Well, Eric Smith, I think that's him shaking the cobwebs out.
Well, sometimes you just don't get the ball tucked away. When people run by you, it sort of distracts you. You lose your focus a little bit.
See, Langston missing it, and Smith was there to hit him to try to keep him from getting to it, but Allen was there.
Hey, just take care of business. Just make a fair catch. Catch the ball, take it there, and don't run the risk.
Is that what you told the Rocket?
No. Catch it, run.
Doc Sanders has the first carry in the second half for the Mountaineers, and he'll pick up about 5.
Nice run, just going north-south, coming back here. Now they'll fake that, they'll come back with the option. They can move the football against this Auburn defense, which is outstanding against the run, because you can't account for the quarterback, Mark.
First two drives for West Virginia. The first one was actually a successful drive, which ended in an interception in the red zone. Second drive, another quick pick. Since then, the Mountaineers have taken better care of the football. Noel Devine getting his first carry in the second half. He was stopped by Tez Doolittle and Sinderic Marks. Devine had 80 yards rushing in the first half, ripped off a couple of long ones, including a 36-yarder. Now it's West Virginia's turn to try to convert on third down. Only the second opportunity the Mountaineers have had on third down tonight. They're 0-for-1. White going to keep it, and White just had just enough to pick up the first down before he stopped by Chris Evans. Let's check in on the field with Aaron Andrews.
Reese, I spoke with head coach Bill Stewart on the way out from the locker room, and he agrees, of course, with Lou Holtz up there talking about our option is clicking right now. We ran the ball well in the second quarter, and he said the key to the success right now in the second half is Pat White running the ball. Guys, Scooter Berry, he has not come out from the locker room yet. They won't give me a final answer about what is going on, but I did hear from somebody on the sidelines it's not likely he'll return.
All right, Aaron, thank you. Light pass complete to Sanders. McFadden, the first one to hit him at about the 43-yard line.
I really like the way that West Virginia has changed the tempo of this game for their offense and defense. Come out of the locker room, stop Auburn in their first position, make them punt it away, get the ball, go down the field, first down, coach. They have the momentum now.
They've made some great adjustments, and if you're Auburn, you've led every game at the halftime, and all of a sudden, here you go again.
Devine shifting to the left side, and White might just set up a little screen to Sanders, and he shot it right past him.
This was a play, Mark, where he could hand it to Devine or he could throw the bubble screen if it's open. It was wide open. Had he completed that pass, it would have been a major game.
All the success they've had on the ground, though, keep running the ball. I like an offense that when you start running the ball and have success, it gives you confidence.
When you throw an incompletion like that, as you mentioned, Mark, you get 7 yards on first down. Now you're third down and three.
White 7 of 12 on the night. And the native of Daphne, Alabama, standing in the pocket and throwing deep for Wes Lyons. And McFadden had tight coverage and a flag flying as Wes Lyons and McFadden were locked up.
This was a call that was well covered. I mean, you'll see the replays. Bump and run. Notice how he backed up. Now he has leverage on him. Keep your hands off him and turn the ball, Mark, and it would never be completed.
Yeah, but I love the play call. I love the matchup. When you've got a guy that's 6'8" with long arms and can go after it, and you're covered by a defensive back at 6 foot.
Number 6 on the defense. Penalty 15 yards. Automatic. First down.
It's always advantage for the offense when it's one-on-one. It's like basketball, getting a rebound.
I disagree with you completely. One-on-one ain't good enough. Two-on-one's an advantage. You got third down. Get a first down. I don't like to throw it where it's one-on-one.
You just don't like to throw to the tight end, so those tall guys. Why don't you see 6'8", throw it to him?
Hey, run up and hand it to him. Don't throw it to him. You lost your rhythm because you went to the passing game. Auburn cannot stop the option when it's executed properly by Pat White.
McFadden was vehemently disagreeing with the call, saying that he was entitled to his position, perhaps, and just going for the football, but
he played it well.
I was hinting at that perhaps that was a questionable flag from this SEC crew, but it bounces in West Virginia's favor, and they've got a first and 10 on the 28. White play action. White throwing for the deep outside, and oh, wide open out there was Jock Sanders, and he dropped it.
Coach, that's a perfect example of trying to run with it and score before you catch the ball. Fundamentally, catch the ball first.
This is a great throw. This is a great throw. You're going to see him out here. Great. Had to throw it right over that guy.
Oh, my. Oh, they're having a look at it in the stadium just as you are at home. And Sanders had it in his hand and couldn't put it away. Now they'll come back with the option, and White knocked down the 25 by Antonio Coleman, the defensive end. Pass rusher extraordinaire, playing the run effectively that time.
That was a fabulous job, Antonio Coleman, of getting upfield, holding his ground, and making the one-on-one tackle on Pat White. Obviously, Pat White's a lot faster, but his quickness is what really gets him going in this option game.
Very well defended. Still a four-yard game, Mark. 3 times 4 is 12, which is more than 10, which is what you need for a first down.
But, Coach, they were 0-for-0 on first down, so they got no yards out of that.
White throwing to Lyons, who is again working on McFadden, and this time McFadden defends it. No flags flying. It'll be fourth down for the Mountaineers.
Why don't you go with a calculator? 3 times 4 is 12. 10 rushes in the first half for 97 yards, 9.7 yards.
Hey, if you're a coach, you don't have to be smart. All you have to be able to do is count to 10. You need 10 yards, 3 tries to get it, possibly 4. That's all. 2 of the 3 passes they threw were incomplete. Picked up 1 run. of 4.5 yards.
So you're telling us that it's easy to be a coach?
Absolutely, it's easy to be a coach.
Here is Pat McAfee from 42 yards out and the all-time leading scorer in West Virginia history. Puts three on the board for the Mountaineers. West Virginia draws closer with its first opportunity in the second half. It's 17-30. During the break, Coach Holtz mentioned how West Virginia has been pounding these kickoffs into the end zone. Auburn's been starting on the 20. This time, Tristan Davis will bring it out. And Davis has an alley. Tristan Davis gets a block, and he's into West Virginia territory inside the 40-yard line. The second kickoff return of more than 60 yards against West Virginia tonight. This one going for 62.
Here you're going to see a replay once again, Mark. They come back here. They form the wedge. He starts up, creates a wedge. They do a great job of staying with their blocks.
Their special teams have been awesome. The onside kick, the two returns tonight. Tommy Tuberio has to be extremely pleased with his special teams thus far.
Well, in West Virginia, the guys kick the ball out of the end zone most of the time. They don't always cover it as hard.
Davis set an Auburn record against Arkansas with 182 return yards. Took one back in that game and almost... And the kickoff return for the touchdown there, and field position flips, and Burns looked to throw it, pulled it down, and gets down to about the 36-yard line. Chris Neild, Doug Slavonic there to make the stop for Mountaineers defense. Defensive coordinator Jeff Castile in Tuberville. His team is involved in yet another nail biter. That's sort of been standard operating procedure for the Tigers this year. As they're looking at a second down play, trying to take advantage of a big play in special teams.
Two tight ends, two wideouts.
Then Tate in the backfield. Burns will adjust to the shotgun. They've had one delay of game penalty tonight as the play clock goes inside five. They get it off. It is Tate, and there is no running room whatsoever. Snowed under by the Mountaineers defense. Forced to the inside first by Quentin Andrews. Also got a little help from Hogan, and also Sidney Glover. He's had a huge night.
Here you're going to see they just get penetration up there. They're not allowed to get any movement at all whatsoever, Mark. And you can't get to the line of scrimmage. It's hard for the back to make a count.
Third down and 9. And one of the differences we've seen in the early going in the second half for Auburn on third down as opposed to the first half, the length they've had to go on third down. Burns, good protection. Burns throwing for Trotney, threw it right at his feet.
Auburn came out the first two series, they ran nothing but eye. Then they came back, they get the shotgun, both the same result, no yardage.
Look at Tuberville getting in Cody Burns' face. Very displeased.
Well,
that last throw.
I know why he's upset. He had good protection by the offensive line, but West Virginia did a fabulous job of coverage down the field.
And he had tried over there. He had an opportunity to complete the pass.
Yeah, but it's easier to protect the passer when they only rush three men. And you can afford to only rush three when it's third and 10.
Well, Durst, who is a great walk-on story, almost gets his punt blocked by Morty Ivy, but the freshman gets it off, and again, it takes a tough bounce. Durst, who played his first organized football game, as you see a flag fly now at the end of this play this year, was discovered by Buddy Gardner, who's a golfer on the PGA Tour, played at Auburn and told the coaches, you need to look at this guy. And he beat out an all-SEC caliber punter in Ryan Shoemaker. But Durst, who's had an all-conference kind of year so far, is not having an all-conference evening at the moment.
He was averaging 43.6 coming into the game. But kicking's like golf, Mark. You have good days, you have bad days.
Plus, the weather may have a factor in this. They're not used to practicing or playing in weather like this when it's below 45 degrees. It's something new to most of these players.
Not only that, the football is much harder, and it's harder to kick.
Well, the patrons here in gold in Morgantown becoming a little irate with the discussion on the field with the Zebras.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Number 28 on the return team. Penalty be happy to the goal. First down.
These fans are tough because that's their first penalty.
It is indeed, but it backs the Mountaineers up, and we'll see if West Virginia can move it again when you come back. More chilly here in the mountains of West Virginia.
That's a Davy Crockett hat.
Yes, king of the wild frontier. Right now, Auburn has been king of the game to this point, but Noel Devine And another big run. That one enough for a first down. He's stopped by Tez Doolittle, and Devine a little bit slow to get back to his feet.
Boy, you got to compliment the offensive line, Mark. What a nice job of maintaining it.
And sliding down the line of scrimmage and doing a great job of pushing the defenders down the field. But I like the way that Noel Devine pressed the line of scrimmage, found his opening, and took advantage of it and picked up some nice yards.
And Devine's going to take a break, and Mark Rogers, the freshman from Lawndale, California, comes in. Devine has 96 yards on 7 carries tonight. Just a very good Auburn rush defense. White throwing it out the flat. They run that screen again, and they complete it this time. Jock Sanders has it up close to the first down marker. There's a flag coming in late. Looked like a face mask.
That was the same play that we talked about, the option, either hand it or throw the bubble. They completed this one.
Gerard Powers, who's coming back from a hamstring injury, gets a face full of face mask as he tries to get Sanders to the ground. Be 15 more from Penn Wagers.
Personal foul, grasping the face mask, number 8 on the defense, 15 yards from the end of the run, first down.
Here's what I don't understand. If we were to look at that again, you would see that the ball carrier had his face mask as well. Both of them had their face mask, Mark. But a ball carrier's allowed to grab it.
You see Auburn struggles in the second half, as we've mentioned, in all 3 of the Tiger losses this year. They, at some point in the game, have held a double-digit lead, as they did once in this game. And now West Virginia has cut it to 4, and they have the ball. Moved from out of the shadow of their own goalpost. They're getting up close to midfield. Rogers has it. Rogers slips a tackle in the backfield. And Mark Rogers has a first down, running through Auburn defenders and getting down to the 42 before Chris Evans stops it.
This is one thing that head coach Tommy Tuberville and defensive coordinator Paul Rhodes did not want to happen. Make sure when you tackle somebody or you touch them, you bring them down. You've got to be the first guy to tackle them, because if they break through that tackle, it's going to be tough to bring them down because the West Virginia backs are so quick in the open field.
Pickup of 14 for Rogers, who was in after Noel Devine was a little slow getting up in this Auburn defense. And just gives up 108 yards per game rushing. Been giving up some ground to the old Golden Blue tonight. Rush coming on White. He misses Bynes, but he will not miss the rest. Antonio Coleman, Chris Evans there to corral Pat White.
It was a defense where they're playing straight man coverage. You're going to see a replay. White has nowhere to go. What a great job they do of always having him corralled in here in the pocket.
Coach, you did a nice job in the blitz on that play. That's a good play for Paul Rhodes, the defensive coordinator, to dial up.
And a linebacker, Josh Bynes, was the one who circled around on the blitz. Sanders has the ball. Sanders is loose. Jock Sanders getting down close to the 30-yard line. Gerard Powers pushing him out of bounds. And Auburn, after a fine play on defense, gives up big yardage, and it'll be a manageable third down after the 15-yard run from Sanders.
Coach, this is what I just talked about. If you're a defender and you get your hands on that ball carrier, you find a way to bring him down.
Well, you have to, but let me tell you, he's only 5'8". He's hard to see.
He's
behind
fast.
Those big linemen. They can't find him, let alone tackle him. What a big play to be third and 18 and to pick up 16 yards.
Second and 18, and now the 3rd and 2 as a result. Option. White. Hit quickly by Merrill Johnson, but not hit soon enough before he picks up a Mountaineer first down, and the Auburn defense on its heels a little.
Boy, does that help your confidence and your momentum and your mental state of mind when you have second down and 18 and you get a first down running the ball in 2 attempts.
Devine back into the game for the Mountaineers, who have a 1st and 10 from the Auburn 30. Again, the give to the running back, and Devine getting up close to 100 yards on the night. He's knocked down by Antonio Coleman. Coleman, a pass rusher extraordinary, told us this week that he had to be very careful when rushing Pat White, that he liked to just use a speed rush and run guys down from behind, but he knew that wasn't going to work against number 5, and he's done a good job of it tonight. They'll move Coleman now to the opposite side on 2nd down. Bynes stepping up in the middle, showing blitz again. Each coordinator trying to get the other to show his hand before the play clock expires. send. Here comes Bynes up the middle. They pick it up. Right, throwing complete. He threw just a little bit behind his receiver, Dorrell Jalloh. And Jalloh had his ninth catch of the year, but just a hair off stride kept him from picking up the first down.
You know how difficult this is for a receiver running full speed across the field to reach back and catch a ball that's running such high velocity and come down with the reception for the big play for the Mountaineers.
But if they run the football, they've not been held to less than 4 yards on almost any attempt when they're in the spread formation.
They're in the eye right now. This has been the problem for West Virginia. Third and short it is. Sanders is pushing his way up in there. And it's been a problem all year, but it wasn't a problem there as Sanders went behind the freshman fullback, Ricky Kovach, who was channeling his inner Owen Smith to try to give the Mountaineers a little attitude in the short yardage situation.
Owen Smith was a fullback that they had at West Virginia previously this year. And not only that, he was just so physical, mentally physical. And he was just tough. He got to the line of scrimmage, knocked guys down, pushed the pile, caught the ball in the backfield. He was Mr. Utility Man for this West Virginia offense.
You just saw the difference in the number of rushing touchdowns that West Virginia's had in the six games this season as opposed to the previous 32. Just five rushing touchdowns for the Mountaineers this year. They had four games last season where they had five or more. This time they're trying to do it in the air. A strike on the slant. Again, it was right to Arnett. They hooked up for a touchdown, and West Virginia's on the doorstep.
Coach, this is absolutely perfect by the offense and execution. Great protection by the guys up front, but look at that one. He knows where he's going with the football.
Just a great throw. And the defensive line gave him the throwing lane to be able to complete it.
Down by four, West Virginia on the Auburn three. Devine's back in the backfield. Mountaineers trying to take the lead. Tiger defense spread out. Bynes coming on the blitz. Bynes throwing it in. Wide open man. Touchdown, West Virginia. It's Jalloh.
What a great game, Mark.
17 unanswered points, and West Virginia has its first lead of the game.
There's just confusion in the backfield. Look, he's wide open. It's a little slide on across the middle right there, and you've got to be able to find out where your man is if you're a defender.
Well, it's sort of a rub pattern by that we're referring to. The two receivers come so close, knowing that they're going to be playing man, they have a hard time switching.
An 11-play, 93-yard drive, and West Virginia, deep in the third, has gone on top of Auburn again. Now the Tigers have to find a way to answer when you come back. Going along swimmingly for West Virginia. 17 straight points. They've finished off an 11-play, 93-yard drive as Pat White threw his second touchdown pass of the night, and West Virginia has its first lead of the evening, 20-17. Now Auburn. The chance to answer. Tigers been down this road several times, and Tristan Davis, who had a big kickoff return the last time he touched the tries again, but this time he'll be stopped just over the 20-yard line. And as mentioned, to win, and now as Auburn takes over, getting deep in the third quarter, the question is, how will the Tigers be able to answer? Burns going to throw on first down, and he's got his man, Rodriguez Smith, and Smith gets out close to the first down, and this is a
they've got their toughest game, so this is a team that may struggle to get to a building if they don't find a way to win tonight.
Burns keeps it on the zone read option, gets up to about the 38-yard line. But conversely, Mark, if Auburn could answer the bell this time, this team has shown some talent. They've shown a little bit of an identity on offense tonight, perhaps for the first time this year. It could bode well for November for them.
It definitely could. Tommy Tuberville can build on that with his team saying, guys, this is how you finish a game on the road in a tough environment against a good football team.
Second and five. Brad Lester has it. Lester has stood up right at the 40. And he'll bring up another third down for the Tigers.
And I think the criticism that Coach Tuberville did is totally unwarranted. Here's a guy who does not have anything but a winning record against every team in the SEC. He's beat Alabama six straight times. He's beat Georgia four times. He's beat Tennessee four straight times. He has beat more top 10 teams than anybody else. I mean, the guy's done a tremendous job.
How long have you been representing Coach Tuberville?
I tell you, you pay me a way, Mark. I represent coaches. I'm just pointing out that in coaching, we don't always look at the great things somebody's done, just what he's done now. I got news for people. New Rodney's dead. He ain't coming to coach Auburn.
Slamming up close to the line and trying to get a first down, and Auburn believes it's got enough for the first down. Big push up front by Tyrone Green. Pat Liebig there to make the stop, but not before the Tigers pick up the first down. You see Bill Stewart chagrin. And I want to go back to this Tommy Tuberville thing. In his press conference last week, he sort of shocked a lot of people by basically taking the podium and answering every rumor that was out there about him, whether it was about his health, his desire to recruit, whether it was about his competitive spirit, whether he had negotiated a contract buyout. He said he's been there. And, you know, he finally had just had enough and said, enough already. I'm going to get rid of all of this. I want everybody to know I'm just fine, ready to coach. Mario Fannin running it for the Tigers and getting up close to midfield. And Tuberville has been wildly successful there. But, you know, Tommy told us this week, he said, hey, you lose three games in the SEC by 9 points. You struggle on offense, have the coaching change that we had midseason. Things are going to get stirred up. That's life in the SEC.
And the internet doesn't help. They could print anything they want without signing their name.
Are you a member of Facebook or MySpace, Coach? You go on there and post those?
You got to be kidding me. Hey, I don't even know how to turn on a computer.
His handle on the internet's Dr. Lou. A nice throw from Burns to Tommy Trott. First down, Auburn to the 40.
And not only this, watch the quarterback, Cody Burns, on this play. He's oblivious to the rush. There's a defender coming in his face, and he just doesn't even see him coming. He stands tall in the pocket, fires the ball down the field to Tommy Trott, the tight end. Look at that. Defender goes right on by him, doesn't even see him, doesn't care.
It was Anthony Leonard coming in, and Fannin almost whiffed on him, but he got just enough. He knocked the linebacker off balance and gave Burns the opportunity to find Trott. And it's Smith back in the backfield. It'll be a little boot. Burns eludes one rusher. He's got some running room. He's going to pull it down. Cody Burns inside the 30, and he hits the deck, but not before. Another first down for the Tigers.
Touchdown by Robert Sands.
That was a smart play by Cody Burns, the quarterback. Watch how he executes on his play. It's a naked boot. He comes out to the outside, but West Virginia hasn't defended extremely well. They have contained, but look at his quickness and athleticism on this.
Boy, it was a great fake. I want to tell you, they ought to come back and hand it to the tailback on the same play, because he would have still been running.
This is a very good answer from Auburn so far. Smith has it, and Smith, off his own play, has gotten nothing to the outside. Inside a half minute to go in the third quarter. And Cody Burns, you see, he talked to us about how much different his mindset is now that he's not looking over his shoulder at Chris Todd. And it certainly exemplified itself, particularly in completion percentage tonight.
I think also the fact that they have simplified the offense. It's not complicated, not as hard read. We throw it off one man, the linebacker, the corner, whatever else the case may be, or else run it, and he's done that perfectly.
Where would you rather be than sitting on the couch checking out the fourth quarter from Morgantown tonight? A 3-point game and a dandy coming up in the final 15 minutes when you come back.